Across the globe have been cancelled due to coronavirus, but London is to be the first city to launch its runway shows exclusively online.
It's going to be a virtual event. It's going to showcase new designs as well as interactive videos and podcasts.
Yeah, we're joined now by one of the organisers, Caroline Rush, and the fashion designer, Priya Ash. Sorry, Priya, I'm going to get your name right.
Anawalia.
Lovely to see you both. Very good morning to you. So, Caroline, first of all, just explain to us how this new look fashion week will work.
Well, I think the first thing to say is that don't expect the runway shows that you said at the top. This is about telling the stories of designers, seeing films of inspiration, seeing the product shown in very different ways than I think people expect from fashion weeks. But we knew when we decided we were going to do a digital fashion week very quickly after lockdown, that the designers might not even have collections to show at this time. So this is very much about celebrating our designers, celebrating the creativity we have in London, using the platform of London Fashion Week to really look into what's happening in the fashion industry at the moment and to welcome the societal debates that are happening around the world.
Yeah, and I'm just thinking, Caroline, I mean, you'll be aware this morning our main story is about problems with the economy and this huge fall, and that affects, obviously, retail is a big part of that. It clearly must be a real concern for the fashion industry.
It is that we hopefully will be in a position to release the forecast of figures of the impact of COVID next week. The initial estimates that we've got are, it will show extremely challenging figures and very much in line with the data that's been released today. And what that means is that we very much need to focus on supporting our businesses. We employ 890,000 people within the UK in the fashion industry. As you said, a lot of that is retail. And we need to make sure where we can that we're protecting those jobs, that we're supporting businesses, and that very much is that we're surviving through this time and figuring out ways to do business better in the future.
Priya, so you've decided not to design a full collection this year,
yes.
I understand. But you're still saying that, you know, you've still been preparing for this virtual showcase. What will we see from you?
So at the virtual showcase, I'll be showing my new book called Jalebi. And it's a book that's been 18 months in the making. And it's an investigation into diversity in the UK, specifically around Southall. It's a photography book shot by Lawrence Ellis. And it was previously meant to be launched before COVID-19. And it was going to have a exhibition where people could socially gather. But because of what's happened, we've decided to use the digital platform to create a 3D exhibition that can actually be viewed by anyone around the world. So it's quite nice because it's allowed it to be opened up to a much bigger audience than maybe a traditional fashion show would be.
Well, that's one of the points, isn't it? I was just reading about Anna Wintour, of course, editor-in-chief of US Vogue, who's admitted, she says, to making mistakes, publishing material that's been intolerant, not doing enough to promote black staff and designers at the magazine, and then obviously taking in Edward Enninful's comments and moves to make sure that there is much more diversity in British Vogue as well. Do you think this is a theme, considering where we are now in the conversation, that's going to be reflected in Fashion Week, this virtual fashion showcase?
I think so. I think that the protests happening globally have kick-started much-needed conversation across all industries, not just fashion. People are really looking at their internal structures, seeing, okay, are we actually doing the best that we can? And I think a lot of people, if they're honest, haven't been doing so well. So I think that a lot of work, you know, there's diverse designers on London Fashion Week schedule. So actually, similarly to my book, these conversations were already being had. But now people are a bit braver. You know, a month ago, I would never have thought I'd be on TV talking about this, to talk about these issues. And also other designers have started to think about how they can support the movement. So I definitely think it's going to be a theme that comes up. But what I want to stress is that it's really important that it's not just a moment for Fashion Week. This is something that needs to really change within systems of all industries. You know, we need to do better across hiring and representation.
Caroline, it's been interesting, hasn't it? Been seeing huge brands across the globe making clear where their support lies and what they are going to do tackling the companies themselves, the structures of the companies, as well as the products they produce and who they use for advertising their products.
Absolutely, and I think is that everybody, or I think practically every business came out with a statement in support of Black Lives Matter, stating that there should be no tolerance for racism, but is that we will be judged by our actions. And as Priya said, this isn't something of a conversation. conversations for now. It's not about just posting on social media. This is about properly reflecting as an industry, looking at what we can do better, and making sure that action is created now. But there's platforms and programs put in for the long term. Is that there's lots of barriers, I think, that as an industry, as society, we need to dismantle. But the fashion industry is a very good industry to do that, because actually it also talks to a very large consumer audience, to global audiences. And so being able to change that and demonstrating how we're changing, I think will also have an influence on society as well.
Priya, just a last thought from you. I mean, obviously you talked about challenges in terms of diversity, but also there are very practical challenges right now, aren't there, to do with coronavirus. So I just wonder how things are, I mean, for you personally, but also about how you see, you know, how your work is going to be.
There's been so many challenges, you know, suppliers and manufacturers have closed. I can't work with my team in the same room. You know, I really miss my team. That's a point as well. It's been challenging, but as a designer, you know, our job is essentially problem solve. So I like how I figured out how to present this work digitally. We're figuring out new ways to get through these challenges. I think that lots more things will become digital, but I don't think it's going to replace human connection. So I think technology is going to play a huge part moving forward in how we produce fashion, how we show fashion, but I don't think it means that we have to get rid of complete social interaction.
Well, that's a good thing, Priya. Good to see you this morning. Thank you very much, and Caroline, thank you as well. So the new style, London Fashion Week, kicking off from today.
Let's get a very fashionable Matthew to tell us what's going on with the weather. Which of your many suits have you donned today? Oh, good morning, the grey one.